another song that everybody loves, 9 to 5. And you talk about that song just came out of being very bored on set.
Well, actually, I wouldn't say it's being very bored. It's just that I was bored always in between because they have so much time between setups with lighting and you just sit around and what are you going to do? You can't really get, you know, into a good book or anything because you don't know when they're going to call you. So on the set, I would watch everybody because this was all about women in the workplace. And part of my deal with Jane Fonda, if I was in the movie, that I would get a chance to write the theme song. So I didn't have chance to get my guitar, go back to the trailer all the time. So I would just kind of roam around on the set, watching everything that was going on. And I would take my nails, you know, because with acrylic nails, it makes like a percussive sound. Can you hear that?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But anyway, it sounded like a typewriter too. So I just started to write little words and things that I would see and things I would think that would fit with that day-to-day 9-to-5 job, getting up and drinking your coffee, stumbling to the kitchen and all. So then I'd go back at night into my hotel room and then put those things down. But I did that over a period of time. And after we recorded the song, I brought all the girls down that was on the show and I played my nails. So I have a credit on the back of the album that says, Nails by Dolly. By golly, Lolly.
Hey, Lolly.
Dolly, how do you manage to play the guitar so well with those nails?
Well, pretty good. I really think that... Actually, I've learned to do it. I really, when I'm serious about my songwriting, I take these off and file them down and, you know, really write good.
Right.
But I've learned to work them with... These work great as picks. There's no problem with this end. But these are the ones I have a problem. But I've learned to do open tuning mostly for the, when I'm writing and stuff. But if I'm really serious about it, I just have to saw them down.
Well, lovely to see you. Where are you, Dolly?
Well, I am in Nashville in my little studio where I work a lot of my things, and especially now that we're all kind of confined to little areas. So we have a little studio set up, and so we're just broadcasting right around home.
Okay, but you are now slowly emerging from lockdown. Am I right in thinking Dollywood is reopened, has it?
It did. Actually, we've been in business now for a few months, and we're doing really well. Of course, we're not as up to speed as when you were there last time, we're doing good, and we've got our fall season and our Christmas season coming up, so we're doing well. We're happy about that.
And anyone worrying about Christmas 2020, I'm here to tell you, Dolly Parton has saved Christmas 2020 because you've got a new album. Is this not true?
I do, and it's called A Holly Dolly Christmas. What
See?
Else?
See? Christmas saved.
But we have a lot of really wonderful things that some classic country, classic Christmas songs, like I saw Mommy Kissing Santa Claus, Holly Jolly Christmas, and of course I wrote a few new songs. We just got a lot of wonderful people on it. It's a fun album, and I just figured we'd all be closed in more this year than ever for Christmas, so I wanted to do something special.
Oh, well, thank you, Sarah. And I believe you're going to be back closer to Christmas with a very special seasonal performance for us. Is that right?
Yes, I got something special for you, a surprise.
Ooh. Dolly Parton, I love you. The Christmas album is out now. The book is out on the 17th of November. And we'll see you closer to Christmas for a special performance. Good night.
Yes, you will.
Thank you
so
much to Dolly
Parton.
Very
much. Been great to be with you.
Love you. Thank you so much. So good to see you. Bye-bye.